going to make us a nice tasty pie to us, Dennis. Now, what did I do with me gadget?
What did you do with your what?
Me gadget. It's a patent pie funnel.
Oh, well, it's up to you, but I never found anything to beat an overturned egg cup.
Oh, we must move with the times, Ina, mustn't we? Now, wherever can it be?
Well, don't look at me. I haven't seen the thing.
Our little Pamela brought it back as a keepsake for her grandma. She bought it in an arcade in Cleveland.
Oh, is that the little pasty one that has to go to the open air school?
Oh, every time I look at that child, I think to myself, Pamela, love, you're not long for this world. You're too good.
Good? Oh, well, of course, you know your own know best. But to me, she was always very good at playing rap and run on my vestry door. And I always think a kid as'll do that has got her foot on the right road to hell. But me, I'm built that way. Is that your gadget?
Yes.
Made of tin, isn't it?
I don't know.
Oh, no doubt about it. That'll taste your pastry.
It never has done.
How do you know?
I've used it often enough.
2 years ago last Whitmonday, you came out of your glory hole and banged your head in. You, am I right or am I wrong?
Well,
yes, you did. Well, you know, when you come out and bang your head like that, it does some funny things happen to you. I don't want to frighten you, but you know that, don't you?
What sort of thing?
Oh, your sense of taste, your smelling sense, they go like that. You know, if you was to bring your landlord up for building your glory hole so low, you could do him for hundreds. And I wouldn't be a bit surprised if this past 2 years you've not been suffering from potato pie funnel poisoning.
Oh, Ina.
Oh, Ina, nothing. Did you once have an unsuspected itch? And have I heard you comment on hot flushes?
Well,
3 times to my knowledge, once on the market, once in the snug, and he had one that day went to help you choose your coconut matting. And that's your door. I wouldn't care, but I haven't tasted ham since last Tuesday.
You are. You've got company.
Oh, good morning, Ina.
To what do we owe the honour?
Well, I thought I'd just pop along and see how you were going on.
Oh, I mustn't grumble. Mind you, it's not what I've been used to.
Oh.
Well, now, you know me, Mr. Tathock. I've always been used to keeping my feet under a good table.
And what's supposed to be wrong with my catering?
Ooh, listen to that, catering. Is that what you call it? So that's what you call putting a neck end of mutton in the oven on in Maudsley Street, is it? Well, and I'll tell you another thing. I don't like the way you have your food in sandwiches.
I don't ask you to do it.
Well, you wouldn't get me to do it either.
It might interest you to know that I like my food in butters, and I don't like your tongue.
And I don't like your leaded lights, and I don't like the linoleum on your rubby floor, and I don't like those photographs staring at me in my naked strip in the privacy of my bedroom, giving me the doodads. But do I say anything?
And you don't like the way I make my tater pie, do you? And you don't like housewife's choice? And you think my good coat's shoddy? Well, it may interest you to know, Ina Sharples, that I've been requested on housewife's choice, and I'm very proud of the fact.
Are you deaf, too?
Hey?
Well, that was your door if you didn't hear it. They make them indetectable these days, you know.
What?
Hearing aids.
Shall I go?
You leave her alone. Do you want to get my best friend a bad name? Hey. I see the amateurs are doing student prints down the road. Golden days when we were very young. Did you ever go to see the student prints, Mrs. Flock?
No, I can't.
Oh, well, I'm not one for going to the theatre myself, but that was a bit of all right, no. Plenty to look at and 2 good intervals.
You know, you've got me a bit in the dark.
Hey, well, I'll illuminate you.
Yes, well, what were you saying about your golden days?
Aye, they were spent in my vestry. You know, Mr. Tathlock, you might not believe me, but there were times... Oh, sometimes I might be boiling an egg or washing out a dishcloth. Suddenly I'd get the feeling God's in his heaven, all's right with the world.
Here's your Vera.
Oh, I am, but you've been talking to her on the front doorstep for the past half hour about...
Oh, I'm going out.
Are you better?
I've not been ill.
Honour thy father and thy mother, eh? Them days is past now, aren't they, Mr. Tathlock?
Mother, I just...
Oh, shut up, you're just second in the queue. Was there anything important, Mr. Tathlock?
Well, Coronation Street's a bit annoyed at what's happened.
Well, what has happened?
You've gone.
Hey, I'm surprised they ever noticed.
Yes, and the residents have written to the committee.
Oh, what about?
You, asking them to reconsider.
But I don't want to be reconsidered. I'm quite enjoying my little bit of retirement, I am. Besides, what words did they use? Nobody showed me any letter.
Well, they said they were fond of you.
Fond of me?
Oh. All of them.
Well, the two-faced sausages. And send it to a place of worship. I wonder that piece of paper didn't burst into flames.
Well, they were only doing the best for you.
Ah, and why shouldn't they? Who was it? Tin hat over her end at the safe Coronation Street from destruction. And tell me another thing. Who was it that poured the bottle of sterilised milk over the incendiary bomb?
I can only repeat, Ina, that they were doing the best for you.
Ah, but is their best good enough?
Well, he might have seen him out.
Where have you been all this time?
Our Colin said in Patago.
Well, I've not come here putting it all over Martha Longo's spirit. She wanted to put a piece of newspaper down.
Ooh. How are you finding it here, Mother?
Oh, it's not all it might be. Things keep waking me up in the night.
Oh, what sort of thing?
Oh, they're not of this world. You know, the other night I was waking... Oh, it was about 3 o'clock in the morning. I was waking up with something breathing in space over the tall boy.
Perhaps it was the cat.
It was more likely to be Martha Longhurst's husband. Cedric Longhurst always had the making of an earthbound spirit. Did you ever know him?
No, not as I remember.
Oh, soaked in it he was, soaked in it. You know, Minnie's very good like that. Might surprise you to know that Minnie Colwell can go into a trance. I'm thinking of asking her to have a go in that there front bedroom. Here, how are you fixed for room?
Oh, we haven't any.
Haven't you? What about your attic?
We've turned that into an investment. We've started mushrooms up there.
Oh, well, it'll do me very nicely here. Once I've got Martha broken in, it'll do me very nicely indeed.
Hey, what are you doing here at dinner time?
I'm helping out.
Well, boy, you're only work nights. I waited for you by the roller
coaster. Yeah, well, Mrs. Knitt's gone to have her feet done. She asked me to stand in. Can I get you something?
No, I don't want anything.
Well, what are you doing here, then?
Well, Laura Nightingale said you were there. I bet you wasn't and now I've lost fourpence halfpenny.
Why, fourpence halfpenny?
Well, all I had in this coat pocket. Ta.
A bit much, isn't it?
What is?
Oh, I bet I know what you're going to do. You're going to sneak to personnel at an inn.
Don't talk, party Doreen.
Well, when have you ever come into Snape's of a dinner time before?
Now, look here,
when
Doreen,
I was on thick fronts and you was on sleeves. I was piecework and you were standard and you were jealous.
Dead rotten jealous. Don't cry me now. I know it's true.
Hello?
Yes.
Now, who was talking to you?
Nobody, but it just so happens I'm standing here behind this counter, not Madeline Noble. Service.
What's up with you? Have you got new shoes on?
Take your shoe off and clobber you one in a minute, Sheila.
She's always saying she's got a passionate nature.
Yeah, well, there are other people in the world besides you, you know. Yes, please.
Could you give me 3 pennies for a threepenny bit, please? Thank
just
you.
Look at her face. Listen here, Sheila Cordon, have you come into this cafe to have your dinner or haven't you?
Oh, she's come to make a meal of me, love.
Just stop that.
Jealousy will get you nowhere, you know. Come on, love, they don't smash in meat pie at the Rover's return. Ta-da.
And all I'm saying is the brewery won't let you.
It was just the same with my Regency stripes. In my considered opinion, the brewery is common. And what do you think you're doing with those? Get them off her before she does herself an injury.
Give it here.
Look, I'm all right.
I said give it here.
Just look at this place. I don't know what's happened to my lunchtime tray. Anybody in the smoke? Well, there were a couple of gypsies who came in with a lot of wooden chrysanthemums, but even they've gone.
Oh, I wonder if they'd have been able to tell me my fortune.
I don't know about that, but certainly knew how to make a mess. Look, will you get a hand brush to that floor?
All right.
The pals have been doing a gypsy dance with on a packet of potato crisps.
Oh, it's a wonder Ian hasn't been in. And has there been any reply to that letter Mr. Tatlock sent yet?
I don't know. I haven't heard anything. The Lord of Heathens.
I suppose you haven't seen Harry Hewitt today, have you?
I tell you straight, I haven't seen anyone but these gypsies. What do you think one of them had the cheek to say to me? You look how I feel, Mrs. Anyway, I don't think that sister of Harry Hewitt's will be ruling the roost there for long.
Don't you?
No, I don't.
Have we got those new wine glasses in yet?
They're in the back, love. Mr. Walker's just unpacking them.
What's that?
What's what?
What am I supposed to be doing?
Get away.
Hey?
I said go away.
Well, what for?
Because I'm having a private with Conceptor. Just a little chat about Harry.
Conceptor's out at
the
back.
I know she's out at the back. If you want to know the truth, we haven't started the conversation yet.
Yes, but...
Now, look here. If you stood here and I explained to you all night, you wouldn't understand because you're the wrong sex.
Now,
just get going when I ask you to.
They're a much nicer shape than the old ones.
They are, aren't they?
You know, he was marvellous the other night.
Was he? It's all right. Mr. Walker won't hear. What did he do that was so marvellous?
Throwing out that trunk, you know.
Throwing out a drunk?
Yes, Mr. Walker.
Oh.
Why? Who do you think I meant?
Oh, Mr. Walker, of course.
Well, this won't get the snob floor done.
Conceptor?
Yes?
You know that same night, a very, very funny thing happened.
Millie Caldwell sat there and completely unburdened herself. Now, she's the last woman on earth, isn't she, to talk to anyone? But that's my story in life. Everybody tells me their troubles. Well, there she was. She poured everything out, how wicked Ina was and how she couldn't have her to stay on account of her mother.
Oh, I didn't know she had a mother.
Oh, well, she has. What was it you were saying about Harry?
Was I saying something?
Yes,
I don't know.
About his sister.
Oh, her. You were saying you didn't think she'd last long.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Mm. Oh, well.
Well, have you had your little chat?
Have you got nothing better to do than come round asking a lot of silly questions?
I can't go on, Mr. Swindley. I can't. I didn't realize what I was taking on, or I'd never have agreed.
Calm yourself, Miss Newton. You must calm yourself.
I didn't get a wink of sleep here last night. Not a single wink.
Perhaps you should have taken a sedative, an aspirin or something.
Mr. Swindley, I only take drugs as a last resort. Trains rumbling over the viaduct. Hooligans caterwauling till all hours. Cats howling. And goodness knows what was going on in the porch. I'll never get used to it. Never. I know I won't. I've always been used to living by the park.
You mustn't upset yourself like this, Miss Nugent.
Oh, would you not be upset, Mr. Swindley? After what I went through last night, I'm inclined to believe that Mrs. Sharples must have been a saint in disguise.
Oh, I wouldn't go quite as far as that.
I would. I definitely would.
Well, of course, there is this letter from the residents of Coronation Street asking the committee to reinstate her.
Do it immediately. At once. I beg of you. They even throw things through the window.
What things?
Mr. Swindley, I don't like letting anybody down, but I cannot put up with this for long. My health won't stand the strain.
Well, it won't be very pleasant, asking her to return. I mean, I certainly don't relish the idea.
And if it's absolutely necessary, I'll go and ask her. I'd go down on my bended knees and beg her to return.
Well, Martha, here we sit in the twilight of our days, happy as pigs in muck.
You speak for yourself.
Oh?
You and I have got to come to some understanding.
What sort of understanding?
We've got to learn to live together.
Oh, we will, Martha. We will. Make no mistake about that. I'm settling in here very nicely.
Oh, yeah, are you?
I am that. Oh, and by the way, you'll want to get a new window cleaner. I got rid of that last one while you were out. That's 2 and 9 pence you owe me. No, I wouldn't go back to that vestry for a gold clock. Not if they would go down on that rag rug on their bended knees. Here, have a mint.
I want to give these a chance to drive.
No, it's all right. Not in a hurry.
Oh. Do you know, I always seem to have to be doing the things. I suppose it's always having my hands in and out of water.
Aye.
A pipe?
No, just down.
Well, you're off your beer then.
Well, no, not exactly, no.
Economizing?
Well, yes, you can sort of put it like that. Actually, I'm saving up to get married.
Were you engaged?
Well, no, not till the 19th, no.
Now, that's something I can't understand. The way I see it, the word is spoken, the cross is plighted, and the young couple is engaged.
That might be all right where you come from, but round here it works out different.
Mrs. Walker, Joe's engaged.
No, I'm not. I keep trying to tell her, not till the 19th.
Oh, how very lovely. It is Christine, isn't it?
Yeah.
I saw you together the other day, and I said to myself, Annie, that's a lovely couple. That's true love, Annie, that is. You didn't see me at the time. You were just coming out of the dog meat shop.
Have you picked out the ring yet?
Well, no, not as...
Well, all I hope is you'll let Christine have some choice in the matter. My husband actually had it on him in his pocket when he proposed.
Now, that's what I call really romantic.
Do you? I don't. I'll never forget it. There we were on the overhead railway over Liverpool docks. It was pouring with rain and it was a miserable moonstorm.
What kind of stone does Christine want?
Oh, I think you'd better ask her that. Good health.
And just you shut up, Sheila Cordingley. And anyway, I'm not talking to you.
It's a free country, isn't it?
Oh, why don't you go and do some washing
because
up?
Because I'm asking Christine about her ring.
Don't as I'm going to have one.
Well, you're getting engaged, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, but Joe's got the modern idea. He thinks we ought to save the money and put it towards a bedroom suite.
Hey, watch it. Do you want to do that?
Well, I don't know. I mean, you can see the sense of it, can't you? But
well, it won't seem like getting engaged without a ring. I mean, you can't go around the bedroom suites showing the girls.
Bedroom suites?
Now, can you? Does he mean in other ways as well?
What do you mean, mean?
Mingy.
I don't know where you've got that idea from. He's not a bit mingy. Of
course he's not. He's just a bit careful, isn't he?
Oh, let's change the subject.
Why? Well, we shall be getting engaged.
Mm, do you?
Why? Well, it's something to borrow off, isn't it?
Mm, you won't borrow much off, Joe.
You sure you're not making a terrible mistake, Christine?
Oh, just listen it. Advice to the Lovelorn by Doreen Lovestock.
Yeah, well, you haven't had to go through getting a divorce.
Neither have you.
No, but my sister didn't. We went through purgatory with her.
Hey, what did she get it on?
Well, they were supposed to be temperamentally unsuited.
Oh, yeah. We had one, but the bell fell off. Mm.
Do you think you and Joe are temperamentally suited, Christine?
I don't know.
What?
I've lost the knack of Lazy Daisy.
Don't look at me for any help.
You are now looking at somebody who might be playing up first team.
Here, when?
Saturday's match.
Oh, dear, I don't know that you got a clean shirt.
Oh.
Oh, David, be normal. I've just had my hair done. I think she's pressed it in a bit hard, don't you?
Never mind about your hair. How did this come about?
We know there's Bruce.
The inside forward?
Well, that's him. Well, he strained her ligaments. Not much, you know, but they're not sure if they get it right in time.
Oh, then you're not playing definitely.
Oh, Danny, she's cheerful.
No, I'm just being sensible. There's no good building on things that may not happen.
Well, anyway, where's our Ken?
He's out.
Well, again, where's he gone?
Oh, don't ask me. He never tells me anything. I'm only his mother. Oh,
well, I'll get something to eat. I'll tell you about it after.
Coffee.
Oh, thanks. Can you put it down somewhere?
You did say you wanted coffee, didn't you?
Yes, I'm just thinking about something.
What?
Oh, nothing that matters.
Well, I'm not going to baby feed you. Come on, drink it while it's hot.
I don't like it too hot.
What's the matter with you?
Well, it's a fella my dad works with. He saw us out together the other night.
So?
Well...
All right. There was a scene?
No, but...
But what?
Well, so hole in the corner, the whole thing.
What whole thing?
All this.
This particular little hole in the corner knocks me back 3.5 guineas
no,
a week.
No, I didn't mean the flat.
Oh, I know what you mean, darling. We're having a fling.
Oh, is that what it's called?
Aye, that's what it's called. There you are.
Oh, thanks, darling.
10p. Do we have to tip you as well?
No, I'm not proud. You just wait till I'm going on that coach trip to Capri.
What's so special about Capri?
It's abroad and they talk a different language. That's what's special about it.
They do that at Rill. Hey, where are you going for your honeymoon, Kate? Yeah, where are you going for
your... I know, I heard it first time. I was just thinking about it.
You know that Fanny Edwards out of Bailey Street?
The redhead with the belt and legs?
That's her. She's a bit flat-chested, though. Well, she got married at the Kong last Saturday. And you know what? They had the do after in the Sunday school. And then him and her, they just went home to her mother's.
Well, I suppose it saves the brand for the going away outfit.
Hey, look who's here. I'll go.
I'll talk with Dad.
No, I'll go over to the counter and torment Doreen for a bit. Hello, Joe.
Hello. Hello, Chris.
You sitting down?
No, I don't really want anything like, you know, I thought we might go out for a bit of a walk.
Well, that'd be nice. It's just coming on to rain.
Well, you got your pixie, haven't you?
I will sit down, eh? Do you want anything? I'll get it for you.
No, honest, I don't really want anything, no.
Well, I'm not to 5 minute cup of tea.
Chris, I do not want anything to eat. Right. What's up?
Nothing.
Oh, see?
Said the blind man.
You know, I don't think it is coming on to rain.
Look, Joe, I don't want to go out, and that's definite. Where are we going for our honeymoon?
Well, I haven't really thought about it, honeymoons. I mean, it isn't as if we're engaged yet, is it? Well, I mean, my Aunt Mary Ellen swears by a woman in Southport. She only does bed and breakfast, though. Oh, Chris, pull yourself together, for goodness sake. Whatever's up with you?
I'm not marrying you.
Of course you are.
No, I'm not. I can't.
But why?
I just can't, that's all.
I think you ought to go and see a doctor, you know. You know, you've been dead nervy lately. I've noticed, love, but I didn't like to say anything. He'll happen to give you a tonic.
Look, Joe, will you get this into your head? I'm not going through with it.
But, I mean, we're getting engaged on the 19th.
What's getting engaged, you mean?
Whatever's made you change your mind?
We're not right for each other.
You and me? Of course we are.
No, we're not, and I should have had the sense to see it before. I'm sorry if I've messed you about, but that's how things stand.
You're making a blustering monkey out of me.
Oh, no, look, there's no need to turn nasty. I'm not just thinking of myself.
That Malcolm Wilkinson chucked you, and then...
If there was any chuck in there, I did it.
Love, I mean... Last night, everything was all right. It was smashing. I went home feeling $1 million.
Ah, well, that was last night.
You can't come out with something like that. You've got to give me a reason.
We'd never get on.
I can do it. I know I'm not much of a catch.
Oh, spare me that one. Yes, you are. You'll get that 2,500 house and more besides, but don't you see, love, we'd never be happy. I mean, every dinner time in the ladies, they hear the wives going on about how they have to niddle £5 more out of their husband's wage packets. Well, I don't want that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't you? Well, if there's one thing in this world I can't stand, it's a penny pincher. Whatever they might have said about my dad.
Say he went bush, didn't they?
Yeah, and do you know why?
Why?
Because he never begrudged anybody anything in his whole life.
Ah, now we've got down to that, haven't we? Taking you a long time to get round to that, isn't it? Why haven't you come out with that before, eh?
Because I've been trying to kid myself that everything in the garden was lovely, but it's not lovely, it's rotten awful.
Don't love this, it's just a mood.
Yeah, and it's one that won't pass.
You think you can do anything, don't you? You think you can say anything, Christine, and it doesn't matter how much you work people, you...
I'm sorry.
Sorry's just not enough. Look, love. What if I bought you the ring?
I suppose I'd have given it you back, but then you didn't, did you?
I just can't take it in. Don't go.
I don't see the sense of me staying here.
Look, we've got to talk this over.
Look, there's nothing to talk over, Joe. We're finished.
I suppose you know what sort of fool you're making me look.
Well, if it may feel any better, tell me you broke it off.
Oh, that's big of you.
Well, that's up to you.
Yes. Is there anything I've done wrong? You think you can get away with murder, don't you? No. Listen, let's go out tonight, eh? We'll go out tonight. We'll go out just as if nothing had happened. Just let's give it another try. All right. That's your lot. Get outside while I've still got control of myself. Because I'm telling you. If you don't, no kidding, I'll chuck you through that. I'll chuck you through that plain glass window. Now get!
Doesn't seem possible.
What?
Well, only 5 minutes ago I was romping round on the vicarage tennis course in a divided skirt. Oh, God, divided skirt, that dates me.
Who cares?
Do you?
What do you think?